Andrew here, Sterilizer Autoclave Solutions, 704-966-1650, option 3 for free technical support. We are talking about error code 544, Charlie 544. During the sterilizer mode, steam temp is high. Chamber temperature reached 6 degrees above the designated sterilization temperature. First cause is going to be maintenance not performed. If you haven't performed your weekly or monthly maintenance, refer to the manual or other video, but you're going to drain the water, clean the filters inside, and possibly replace gaskets. But if you haven't done that in a while, let's start there. The next thing is the sterilizer is unlevel. That's pretty self-explanatory. Make sure it's on a level surface. We don't want the front way higher than the back or the back way higher than the front. That could pose a problem. Then it's getting either too much water or not enough water. All right, then we're going to go temp sensors possibly malfunctioning. You're going to open the door, you're going to pull all the instruments out, all the trays out, and in the back there's a temperature probe. It's right in the middle of the chamber. You're going to clean that with a non-abrasive or with an abrasive pad, also speed clean and distilled water. You're going to wipe it dry, check that nothing is touching or crowding, so we alleviate that when we pull all the instruments out and the trays. We shut the door, we run an empty cycle. If the problem persists, then it's going to be either the board is failing or the temperature sensor is failing. If you're willing, we can do a couple tests. It's an output test of the PC board, or a resistance test of the temperature sensor. The next thing will be pressure leaks. So when we're running, when we pull the instruments out and we run an empty cycle, we can stick around and watch to see if the door gasket's leaking. You want to make sure obviously that that's in place. Want to replace this. It says every year, but they don't really last that long. Always have a backup for door gasket and dam gasket. We're going to check for leaks underneath the unit. There could be the heating elements leaking, could be the fitting underneath the belly of the chamber that goes to the valves is leaking, could be that. The manifold block here is leaking, either at the stem or the plunger. Also, there's an air, so fill vent, vent valve, fill valve, vent valve, and then you have the air vent bellows back here. Also, there's a pressure relief valve. If that gets stuck open, it will leak under the bottom right corner. So we have a couple things there. If you can take the cover off and we can run a cycle that way, then you can see these things actually failing real time to get a more accurate diagnosis. But at that point, I'd just say, send it in to a technician. Okay, Charlie 544, pressure leaks continued. Pressure transducer tubing. Make sure this isn't leaking. You'll have to take the right side panel off, obviously, Phillips screwdriver. Take two out here and one the side here. You can refer to our other video for that. But make sure this isn't leaking. Get a flashlight. You can look under here when it's running or back here and see if you see any steam or hear steam. Could be the heater element is malfunctioning. You can inspect the heating element, you know, during your weekly and monthly maintenance. The heating element, pull the tray out like so, but the heating element's right here. You don't want to make sure that there's no like dirt in the bottom of the chamber. That's actually the heating element deteriorating and pitting. And then, so that is also an issue. Other than that, we would do like a heater element relay output test. We can do that. You need an inductive ammeter for that one. It could be, which is leading me to the PC board, it could be that the heater relay is failing on the PC board or the fuse holders are bad. But we can fix that. We do PC board repair. So Charlie 544, verify unit is operating within designated program parameters. Okay, so if you're adjusting these parameters, there's only so far you can go one way or the other. It's on a case-by-case basis also, so I would call and talk to a technician before you start putting these presets way out of whack. That's pretty much it, Charlie 544. If you like this video, please share it. Please subscribe to our channel for more error code videos, how-to videos on all autoclaves. Thank you.